it's on your side. News 12, first at 5, continues.
The founder of Brown Beauty Magic has passed away, but her legacy lives on. We'll tell you how her company will still be able to inspire so many young lives in our area.
But first, Augusta is still working to get fully operational after a cyber attack last week that has crippled so many parts of the city.
Yeah, we just got an update from the mayor that we're working on now. Augusta Commission met earlier today, and we're supposed to shed some more light on this issue, but they were not taking any questions or giving a statement at that time. The specially called meeting started out with a motion to go immediately into executive session. For nearly 2 hours, the commission chamber sat empty as commissioners discussed cyber issues behind closed doors. Now, News 12 spoke with Mayor Garnett Johnson yesterday over the phone. He told us that he would issue a statement in person today, answer questions that we had about that meeting. That did not happen. We just got that statement that says an unknown actor gained access to a certain computer system, but the city has not been in contact with the cyber group claiming responsibility. While the mayor has given us updates, we've heard little on the actual investigation. Meanwhile, families are feeling the impact of these cyber issues across the city as a whole, especially in our court systems. Court watchers say defendants have to write down their own criminal history and paperwork isn't being presented.
The backlog is only growing, you know, and in some ways the system is protected because it's so paper-based, but in normal times, it's so inefficient to the detriment of taxpayers, the people in the jail, this entire community. They're just facing crisis after crisis, and this community is not stepping up to say this should not be operating this way.
The mayor's statement says Augusta 311, Augusta Transit, Augusta Utilities, Environmental Services, and the Tax Commissioner's Office are all back up and running now. That was in the most recent statement that he just posted a few minutes ago. Coming up all new on News 12 at 6 o'clock, we're looking more into how these cyber issues are impacting people involved specifically in the court system. But switching gears to weather now, we're going to toss things over to First Alert meteorologist Mikkel Hanna-Harding here. And Mikkel,
we're forecast coming up in just a bit.
Thanks, Mikkel. A man is dead after a shooting earlier this morning in Louisville. The Jefferson County Sheriff's Office says 43-year-old Roosevelt Alexander Jr. was shot in the chest and pronounced dead outside a home on Wren Lane. That's just outside of Louisville. This investigation is still in its early stages. Still no word on suspects in this case.
A downed utility pole causing problems for some drivers on 15th Street near the Medical College of Georgia. This was the scene earlier when the pole was down at that location. Utility lines were down and in the roadway. Kind of dangerous there. One witness said there appeared to have gotten tangled in a vehicle's wheels. Around 2 this afternoon, it was impossible for traffic to get through 15th Street because of the Augusta Fire Department vehicles and debris in the roadway.
On Tuesday, we told you about the death of Dorian Scales, the founder of Brown Beauty Magic, a company focused on using princesses and superhero characters to highlight diversity in our community.
Our Maria Sellers spoke with the co-owner of that company to find out what's next for them and how they plan to keep her legacy alive.
Dorian's always going to be with us, and Dorian's going to live on.
Dorian Scales started Brown Beauty Magic Royal Events to serve the underrepresented children in the community.
What she was wanting to do was important to like go in these low income areas and to do stuff mostly for free, especially for people who can't afford stuff like that and for people who don't see themselves.
The service came through singing, dancing, and princess dresses.
She said it was like an escape for her, you know, because the children just loved her. But she gave her love to other children, so they would know that they could get love from somebody. You know, they don't have love themselves, they could get it from somebody.
The company says they plan on keeping her message and mission alive under a new name.
We're changing the name slightly to Brown Beauty Magic, Dorian's Character Company, because we always want to say her name.
And Prince says while it was a tough decision to continue, she knows it's what Dorian would have wanted.
I didn't want to at first. I was like, we have to. But she would always say, you know, if I'm not here anymore, will you guys carry it on for me?
It's community support that will make it possible.
They saw what she was about. And I know we're going to get the support that we need because we've already gotten so much outreach.
To continue her vision.
You know, children should be able to enjoy it, no matter, you know, what economic status they are or what color they are. We just want them to come out and be able to see real princes and princesses.
says they've had people reach out through social media to show support from other states and even other countries.
Yeah, definitely going to miss her impact here in our community. They also have the support of Dorian's family and friends to continue her mission. They also say that in lieu of flowers to the family, they say that they would like people to donate to the Broken Outreach Ministries to help people with mental health and addiction problems as well, challenges. So they're doing a good thing to try to help a lot more people in her honor there. Well, it's a new solution to an old...
Breaking news, a man behind bars in Richmond County charged with the murder of 15-year-old Joran Gaynor. Gaynor was shot and killed at the Get and Go last evening. Derek Lyons Jr. is charged with murder, two counts of aggravated assault, and possession of a firearm during the commission of a crime.
Lyons Jr. is being held at the Charles B. Webster Detention Center. We'll continue to keep you updated as this investigation continues. But switching gears to weather now, we're going to take a look.
Approaching 90 and a lot of sunshine in the forecast for your Saturday. So a beautiful weekend shaping up, still staying mostly dry Sunday. Those rain chances bump up to about a 20% chance. And then as we head towards Tuesday through the middle of next week, those rainfall chances just a tad bit higher.
All right, thanks for that, Mikel. Officials in North Carolina are continuing to investigate a plane crash. The small plane experienced engine failure shortly after takeoff Wednesday afternoon from Long Island Airport.
It went down in Lake Norman, where Good Samaritans were on the water ready to help. Cam Gaskins reports.
It was just amazing that nobody got hurt and everybody walked away from this.
Long Island Marina owner Ed Pyle says he's seen his fair share of planes come to gas up at his marina, but he's never seen what he saw Wednesday afternoon.
It was just hard to believe. At first, I didn't think it was a plane. I mean, I actually thought it was maybe a sailboat because we just could see parts of it at first.
Pyle says he didn't actually see the plane's hard landing. He only heard the noise. But what he did see, he says, warmed his heart.
It happened so quick, but within just a couple minutes, several other boats came right to the rescue. So it was Good Samaritans came to help them.
Both men on board the plane were assessed and released by Catawba County EMS with minor injuries. But Pyle says he's thankful this hard landing didn't turn into a tragedy.
It could have been really a lot worse, especially if there wasn't people out there to help.
As that plane sits on dry land tonight, Pyle says the boating community on Lake Norman played a big part in saving the day.
Everybody will help each other when you're out on the water, because it isn't like a car where you can get out and walk. So you always have to count on everybody else helping.
One passenger was on board with the pilot. Both suffered minor injuries, which is kind of amazing when you see that.
Yeah, it's great to see people coming in and help those people in a situation where they need to get out.
Yeah, a lot of people run away from something like that, not to something like that.
I think it speaks a lot about the boating community, too. When you're out in the water, you know, someone needs help, go help them.
Yeah, go help them.
Because if you were in that situation, you wanted to.
Oh, yes.
Well, you probably know Echo devices are always listening for someone to say the wake-up word, but do you know it records when it thinks it hears the wake word? Well, when Live at 5 continues, we'll show you how to hear your voice, history, and delete it all.
First Alert Radar, powered by Jim Hudson Lexus Acura Infinity. Cracks in your brain. If your house is beginning to settle, don't settle for anything less than Ramjack Foundation Repair. Ramjack's American-made products are ISO certified and recognized by the International Code Council. Don't do it twice. Do it right. Rely on Ramjack.
The FCC has fined Amazon $25 million, accusing the company of saving recordings by Alexa even after customers asked to delete them. The commission says Amazon has been keeping recordings in geolocations of children who have talked to the Echo devices for years.
You're supposed to spell out A-L-E-X-A because you just set it off. And how's
this
all
across? I'm sorry.
Our area.
Speaking to you right now, I apologize.
It's recording you,
it's
Will.
It's a weak word, all right?
Our consumer tech reporter, Jamie Tucker, says if you haven't checked, A-L-E-X-A may have recorded you even when you don't say her name.
What the Tech, sponsored by WOW Internet.
I will say the name just once because it will likely trigger your Amazon Echo device to record the conversation. Have you ever wondered if these things really do listen all the time? They absolutely do. They're listening for someone to say the wake word, Alexa. And when it hears that word, or just assumes it hears that word, it actually records the conversation for a couple of seconds.
You can check for yourself. Go into the app, tap settings, and then privacy.
There you'll find Review Voice History. By default, it will display all of the recordings for the day. You can change that to the last 30 days or the entire history. You'll likely see years worth of recordings, all saved on Amazon servers. Look or listen to the ones that are labeled audio could not be understood. You may hear sound from the TV when someone said something similar to the trigger word, such as Alaska. Amazon saves those, it says, to improve its functionality. But do you really want Amazon to collect that data and save the recordings? You can delete the recordings by date or all of them at once. If you're really concerned about this, you can disable the Echo's microphone, though you'll effectively make the device useless when you want to ask for help. And you can also change the device's trigger word to computer, Echo, Amazon, or change your name to Ziggy. I found using the name Ziggy significantly reduced the number of incidents when Amazon recorded my conversations. If you go look at your voice history in the Amazon app, you will likely see that it recorded the conversation from the television and everything happening in your room at the very top of the story when I said her name. That's What the Tech. I'm Jamie Tucker.
Her name, that's right. The FTC ruling calls for Amazon to delete voice recordings of children and to change its practices. The proposed order still must be approved by a federal court judge, but we'll keep you posted.
When the final out of the GHSA, when the final out of the GHSA Class 3A Baseball State Championship was recorded, the Harlem Bulldogs ended a 37-year championship drought. Whether it was scoring three runs in their final at-bat of Game 1 to take the lead, or somehow turning a 1-2-3 double play to get out of a bases-loaded jam with no outs late in Game 2, the Bulldogs kept us all on the edge of our seats to win their first state championship series since 1986. Head coach Jimmy Lewis has led Harlem through all the ups and downs over the past 44 years. News 12's Nick Proto and I caught up with Coach Lewis to reflect on his Harlem Bulldogs reaching the mountaintop.
And being 70 years old, it's got to rank as number one. It's got to be the greatest feeling I've ever had. You go 37 years, that's pressure. 37 years worth of pressure mounting on your back. Am I ever going to win another one? Maybe it's time for me to hit the road. I'm over the hill. I don't know. And then, boom, all the pressure's off. We win it. And, you get that feeling back of when I first started.
You can watch our full 15-minute interview with Coach Lewis on the WRDW12 YouTube page. Two more players on the Westside Boys basketball team signed their letters of intent today. Guard Amari Tillman signed the dotted line to play for Savannah State University, while forward Kalon Hudson will be taking his talents to Spartanburg Methodist College. Both of these young men played major roles in the Patriots' ability to win back-to-back state championships.
I'm so happy for those guys. I had the pleasure of doing a story with Kalon and Amari, so I'm happy to see them going on to the next step. As far as rainfall, staying mostly dry for the weekend, not really until next Tuesday, do we see more rainfall coming back.
Yes.
Forecast one last time coming up.
Y'all feeling lucky.
Rainfall chances dry again for your Monday, and those rainfall chances coming back by Tuesday.
But at least we've got a nice weekend.
Yes.
That sounds fantastic. Thanks, Mikhail. That's it for us live at 5. Richard Rogers, Laura Warren, up next for News 12 at 6 o'clock.
If you don't have what it